England and Pakistan.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
Everything I do, so instinctive and so passionate. Every word I move, so descriptive like an adjective. I got a vendetta against people who patented being negative when you should be getting after it. I got facts over tracks, this and that. Spitting slow, spitting fast. I could roast, I could gas. Think I'm okay at last, but I don't know if that can erase all the past. And the pettiness, a reflection of the emptiness. Hilarious, you think you're worth my time, you're delirious. Mysterious, because you hide behind a fake exterior. Inferior, you know I'll always be a bit superior. Get off of me, this ain't no humble brag. I want you to hear words, you can say them back. I want you to feel free from the chains at last. And to believe in what you got, it was built to last, yeah.
Now that I've been put through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
Gonna learn the consequence of being incompetent. Mental health is confidence, dreams into modestness. I'm not here to save the day, that's for you to take away. I could play a million mind games, but instead I say something not illogical, something that is typical. Rub it on and watch it go, make yourself unstoppable. Dreams are irresponsible, but they're always possible. If you just believe, you could be so remarkable.
Thoughts in my head, a collage and they spread. I'll be great one day, going off of my meds. No, I'm not giving up, no, I'm not giving in. I will make it to the top, taking off in the wind. I gotta make it, I'm saving every day to taste it. I'm patient, but my mind, it can hardly take it. I'm chasing a dream that I've had for several ages. A vacant modern kingdom for the taking.
Now that I've been put through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
I don't ever slow up, no, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up.
Bowlers, so that's why we decided to bat first.
And Saklan Mushtaq gets the game.
Yes, he's in. Saklan is in. He's definitely one of the best off-spinners I've seen in recent years. So I think he'll be the definitely future prospect for Pakistan.
I have to ask both of you Lancashire lads this. What do you make of the pitch?
No idea. I have no idea, and others have no idea either. So let's see how it plays. I hope it plays okay.
Let me check with the England captain. Morning, Mike.
Hi.
Have you ever seen one like this before?
No, I haven't. Not for a long time. I've never seen one like this here. So it's the same for both sides. Got to go out and play on it.
What about the England team?
Well, we've gone with just five bowlers. Played an extra specialist batsman, if you like, here. Because we think runs might be at a premium.
Yeah. No Pete Martin?
No, we've gone for bowlers who hit the pitch. Because I think that might be the better option here.
The ball might disappear. Anyway, good luck.
Thank you very much.
So we have the umpires, Nigel Plews and George Sharp. Third umpire, John Holder, and Peter van der Merwe from South Africa is the match referee. Confirmation for you, Pakistan won the toss and are batting first. Let's join their innings now with the fifth ball of the second over. There are three runs on the board. Syed Anwar is facing.
Alam Mulally has joined with Darren Gough now as the opening pair for England. Don't give him much width. That would have been one of the instructions, even a plea from Michael Atherton. Syed Anwar is a magnificent player. He's at his best if he has room for the offside stroke.
And you see these cracks that run right down one side of the pitch, where Aamir Sohail is batting and Bilali is bowling right into those cracks for the left-hander. What was about the right-hander is facing, but for the left-hander, it's dodgy.
Beautiful slow ball. In both forms of cricket, Gough has nice changes of pace. He's got a good, quicker delivery. He can bowl reverse swing or swerve, and he has a very good slow ball, which is that one.
Yes, and he's bowling intelligently by trying to bowl pretty straight, almost at the legs of both left-handers. He's trying not to give them any room on that offside, and he's also got the chance of hitting one or two cracks round about leg stump. Well, that's a bit of a fluky edge there. Gough just gave him a touch of room, not much. He's trying to steer it. Wasn't quite intentional, but it's got four runs.
That's beautiful straight. Not much room outside the off stump there for the left-hander side, Anwar, but he played that very well.
Not easy batting at the end where the cracks are for the left-handers. You're not quite sure of the bounce. Look at that one, hardly carrying to Alec Stewart.
Very good Yorker. Nicely bowled by Darren Gough.
Time for the first bowling change of the morning. Dean Headley from the Stretford end.
Well, these Pakistani batsmen have come from the true bounce that they've just had at the Oval Test match. Here they've got one, the pace is slower, the ball's keeping low quite a bit, not coming on, and it's frustrating them.
Up and over. And there's no man down at deep square leg at this stage of the match, so four runs. Inside edge, and not far away from the stumps, but a good stop by Alec Stewart.
Syed Anwar just riding his luck a bit. Just throws the bat at the ball, and the bounce that I've mentioned is not true. Certainly not the same sort of pitch he's been used to at the Oval.
That's four runs, that's well worked. Bilali is operating to an offside field. There's no one on a boundary anywhere on the leg side. And Syed Anwar really had to manoeuvre that and to get himself across onto an outside off stump to get it there. That's gone really low. Nothing Aamir Sohail could do about that. This is the danger part of this pitch. At some stage, one's going to come through straight and low, and that's going to be the end of it. That's brilliantly played. That's not such good bowling from Dean Headley. Ronnie Irani, the new bowler from the Warwick Road end. Great shot. Well, four runs signalled by Nigel Plews. Syed Anwar just hitting through the line, giving himself space to fling the arms at it. And he's forced a change in the field now, long off having to go back. Oh dear, Another slice of luck. And Dean Headley, well, that's going to be four. I think it's going to be four, put it that way. Might need someone to check it, if they want to. If they don't, it'll be two. Well, Dean Headley was over the rope and still making contact with the ball. In fact, they've run three. Just going to have to hurry. That's well fielded. Well, it was always going to be tight, and it needed a direct hit. Aamir Sohail desperate for runs this morning. And that would have been desperately close. And 50 it is. 50 coming up in the 17th over. And largely due to the efforts of Syed Anwar. He's 44 not out, whereas Aamir Sohail has contributed just five. And maybe it could be more. There was that incident on the long leg boundary with Dean Headley that might have added one to the score. And there was this shot from Syed Anwar off Ronnie Irani, beautifully struck over and quite a long way over mid-off. And the question is, where exactly did it land? Which side of the rope? And we think that's six. Michael Atherton deciding to make a change. And it's the first sighting today of Robert Croft, the off-spinner. Fielded by Darren Gough. And George Sharp just deciding to be absolutely safe about this one, calling for the third umpire. Robert Croft's first delivery just pushed away on the offside, and the batsman went immediately. That's going to be in their favour, even though Darren Gough swooped one-handed through on the run. It's close, but not quite close enough.
A big test for Croft, this, his first one-day international. That's his first-class season, 66 wickets at 30 apiece. Bowled extremely well in the test match, but this is quite a different challenge, with Pakistan really looking to play all their shots. Oh, bad fielding that. That doesn't help the cause at all, Mullally. Syed Anwar, one for his half century. And that's it. Syed Anwar, very good half century, and a difficult pitch. His 12th half century in One Day Internationals. That's great fielding by Matthew Maynard. And Robert Croft has the problem now with his captain, Michael Atherton, of deciding whether he should continue during this third over around the wicket of these left-handers. He can bowl equally well over the wickets at midland leg. That might prove even more economical. Very well bowled. That turned Syed Anwar around there. Ronnie Irani now to bowl his fifth over, 82 for no wicket. Another big bang, that's got a stir up in the air, man under it, and he's out. Syed Anwar's gone for 57. And Mullally, after a sketchy time fielding on the ground, has proved himself a safe pair of hands in the air. 82 for one. That's a fine innings by Syed Anwar. 57 of 75 balls on a pitch that's not really helpful to stroke making. May well prove a decisive innings that. Ijaz Ahmed is the next batsman in. So the first wicket goes down in the 24th over, 82 for 1. Syed Anwar, top class innings there, 57.
It's bad luck for Croft. He beat the batsman in the flight. Bottom edge, and it went through slowly enough to Stewart that the batsman could get back. Well, they'll look for a second here. That's good fielding from Headley, but to no avail. Batsman so quick to come back.
Headley picking up quite smartly and hitting the stumps direct. I think Aamir Sohail was comfortably home. He didn't bother to run his bat in.
Trouble here. Missed the throw. Well, Atherton couldn't see whether or not Stewart was there, moving up from the wicket-keeping position. He was with his back to the stumps, had to turn and throw in the one action. Just a question of whether or not Stewart could make it in time.
Yeah, a lot of hesitation here by the batsman, a yes and a no, and finished up. Ijaz was stranded in the middle of the pitch, just vainly trying to get back. Up for Pakistan off a leg by.
Good fielding once again. Atherton has distinguished himself three times in the last two overs with excellent ground fielding. The fielder, bit of a mess in fact. That shows, well, that he could be okay, and it might just be the runs accrued from the running between the wickets, but then this shows that he is now touching the rope and the ball gets out of his hand there. So you've got a boundary, and perhaps they're having a little conference now about those extra runs that should have gone to Pakistan. No one seems to have been calling for adjudication from the third umpire today. Third umpire is John Holder. Match referee is Peter van der Merwe.
35 overs gone. Pakistan nicely placed at 122 with the loss of just one wicket, and the likes of Inzamam Al-Haq, Salim Malik, Wasim Akram still to come. Very well taken by Alec Stewart. All it means is that what is now one wide could have been four. Well, that's the luck of the draw in one-day cricket. No luck for Darren Gough. An edge that races away to the third man boundary fine for Ijaz. And up comes the 50 partnership. Well, Sohail is trying everything. Every ball has a full swing. Every ball seems to have a different shot. Try and counter it. Talk about unorthodox. Just wide of the man at short extra cover, and that's four runs. Bowling this time, and Robert Croft celebrates as Aamir Sohail tried to get that one over deep mid-wicket, trying to vary the theme, and he falls just two runs short of his 50. And Robert Croft's had a good day. He's bowled straight, got this one just to turn a little bit from just outside leg stump, and as Aamir Sohail heaved across, that was the end of all that. He's gone for 48. Pakistan are 141 for 2. Wasim Akram, the new batsman, he's promoted himself up the order, with no doubt the express view of maybe attacking the spinner. Very much a man who is capable of wielding the long handle, a big striker of a cricket ball. That's hiked away, just past Michael Atherton at mid-wicket. And Mullally not quite quick enough to get it. Well, that's gone high, down towards long on. One bounce, two bounces, four runs. 12 off that over from Irani. Now there's a chance of two, maybe three, maybe four. So take the options, eventually it's four runs. The ball was straight enough, and the sweep shot just got enough bottom edge on it to give it the impetus to take it down to that long leg boundary. That's bowling. That's clever bowling. Wasim just trying to repeat the shot from the ball before, and getting his front foot just too far across. So the experiment of promotion has not really succeeded. Wasim has gone for six, is it? Bowl round his legs. And another victim for Robert Croft. Inzamam Ulhaq is the new batsman. Just had to wait his turn as Wasim Akram tried the experiment of promoting himself. But he's at the crease now. Pakistan 160 for 3. And we're just under 10 overs to go. That's a fine shot. Nicely placed. And just avoiding the dive too. Well, that was perfect placement by Ijaz Ahmed. Leek Knight looked as though he might be making ground quick enough to catch it, but in the end, just out of reach. It was actually very nicely struck and timed.
Powerful miscue, and well taken. With a big hit, powerful swing, top edge, and Ronnie Irani has come around. He's taken the ball in slightly awkward fashion, but it looked as though it was swirling away in the breeze. A very strong wind blowing here at Old Trafford. In the end, it was well caught.
Yeah, Sijaz is cross with himself because this ball went up off the face edge to long on. He was trying to drag it wider through mid-wicket. Very sensible innings, 48 of 56 balls.
Owen Khan is the new batsman.
Yes, England will be pleased with the situation now. They've got two new batsmen at the crease. Inzimam's not really got settled yet. Very few deliveries. Moin Khan, the new batsman.
Lloyd is the fielder away at deep square, but that's gone good 15 yards to the left of him. Nice shot from Inzimam. Fielder at mid-wicket, a bit of trouble picking that up. Now Darren Gough about to bowl his ninth over. Leave Dean Headley to bowl out the rest of the innings. Oh, that's worth a shout. Must have got a touch, I would think. Indeed he did. I don't know what's happened to his bat or the pitch, but I assume it's a hunk out of the bat.
Well, Darren Gough's got the right idea. He started bowling Yorkers every delivery this over, and they're very difficult hit, as Inzimam found. He's got the inside edge of the bat, off went a piece of it, and then he'll have to swap the bat eventually. Good bowling. Well, that'll go for four. The idea was right from Darren Gough to bowl another Yorker. But it was just a low full toss that Moin Khan managed to get to the mid-wicket boundary. 200 up, 203 for four.
Now that's got him with some excellent bowling. He's been aiming that ball in from outside the off stump all the time. Very good effort from Darren Gough, but the batsmen are pushing on as they have to do. We're into the 47th over now. There's good cricket from Gough, no inside edge there.
Moin Khan at this stage of the game has to play some shots. Although he's disappointed, he's done the right thing, 10 off 9 balls. Salim Malik is the new batsman.
Dean Headley has the responsibility of bowling this last over. So far, he's tried very hard to keep the ball up in the block hole. Ball there. Top edge. No way the man at third man could cut that off. Go for two there. Inzimam can't get back, so the Pakistan innings finishes at 225, the loss of 5 wickets, a full 50 overs, and a good performance by Pakistan to get back after a slightly indifferent start.
Yes, it really was a struggle for Pakistan at the start to score, that is, without slogging. Aamir Sohail up the front there scored his 48 of 117 balls. But Syed Anwar was much more fluent, and then lovely runs came from Ijaz Ahmed and especially from Inzimam ul Haq. 225 for 5. Feeling I had was that the slower the bowling, the less easy it was to score. But Mullally bowled well, 10 overs, 3 maidens, 1 for 31, and Robert Croft 2, 10 overs, 1 maiden, 2 wickets for 36. And so England required 226 to win the match at 4.52 runs per over. We join the innings now with the third ball of the first over. One run's been added. It's Wasim to Stewart.
That's a nice shot from Alec Stewart. Four sweetly timed runs to get him off the mark. The second over now to be bowled by Vakar Yunus. That one did keep low. Now, this has been the big question all day. How well or badly would this pitch play? It's never looked good. And as Vakar Yunus tried to cut that one in from outside off stump. Oh, good shot. Just flicked away. There's no real pace in this pitch. Uneven bounce there maybe, but no great pace. That's past gully again. Very well run. Nick Knight really putting the pressure on. He ran the first one quickly, always with two in mind. And really sprinted back for that second. Wazim Akram with 199 matches under his belt now. The entire England team against him today has only got 176 to their names. Oh, played. Nick Knight down the track. Supreme confidence. And he's obviously intent on making a mark here very, very quickly. Down the track a couple of paces, on the up. And threw mid on for four. Another chase for Atara Rahman. So, an early bowl for Saklane Mushtaq. Big shot. And four runs it is, too. Well, that's the way to attack. Nick Knight does this all the time for Warwickshire.
Yes, I think the young spinner bowling at Nick Knight, he's going to need somebody at deep mid-wicket. That seems to be his favoured shot, whether the ball's turning into him or away from him.
Well, it can't be out. It's pitched outside leg stump.
Yes, he's going to have to attack just outside leg stump, spinning the ball into the pads of the batsman because he has no protection on the offside boundary, but that ball clearly pitching outside leg stump as far as LBW is concerned. Certainly will be a good run-saving delivery.
Michael Atherton due in at number three.
Well, that's a 50 up for England. Splendid performance. 9.1 overs, that's very quick time. Pakistan bowlers are going to need some better ground fielding than they've had so far. Too many twos by the fleet-footed Nick Knight. That was Inzimam falling over. Difficult to bowl well unless the fielders back you up with some splendid fielding.
Nicely played. And really, these England openers have gone at something of a lick here, certainly compared with Pakistan. And there's a comparison. That's it. First wicket's gone. Knight's gone. Beautifully bowled. Excellent late movement outside the off stump, traps Knight. $57 for one.
It was a quality delivery, this. Bowled right in the channel, just left him right where those cracks are. In the end, Nick Knight can be forgiven for getting out, because it was a really good delivery. He's played very well, 26 of 34 balls, giving England an excellent start. And he got a very good delivery to get out to Court Mohin Ball Wasim for 26.
So at 57 for one, Michael Atherton comes to the crease. Quite a shout as Atherton tries to improvise a shot off Saklin Mushtaq. Yeah! Yeah! Extraordinary run that.
There's a great opportunity here for a run out, but it's Wasim Akram, the captain, makes a right mess and fumbles it. Well, it was bound to happen sooner or later. A young off-spinner bowling at the right-hander, somebody was going to launch him into the outfield.
An interesting comparison after the 15 overs. Atherton comes in to this side today. He's wasn't in the last test match, but played early on. Quick one. Oh, great shy there by Wasim Akram. Rather a cheeky single that from Michael Atherton. Well, that would have been out. 80 for one. Atherton moves on to 11. Alec Stewart on strike is 39. In the air. Oh, dropped him. Went to Wasim Akram's strong left hand, but even Wasim stretched out, couldn't make it. He's hit that well. A rich sound of bat on ball. Went square on the leg side. There was a man at deep mid wicket who simply had no chance of making the ground.
It's OBW. That guy Yunus has got him. The ball slanting in from outside off stump. Umpire George Sharp has given Stewart. That's very well bowled. Middle and leg. It's about as plumb as you can get without it hitting middle. And Alex Stewart trying to force away on the onside, probably through mid-wicket, is out too short of his half century. 48 from just 58 balls. Graham Thorpe is the new batsman. 98 for 2. We're in the 20th over. Knight out for 26 and Stewart for 48. Mushtaq Ahmed now from the Warwick Road end and Graham Thorpe to take strike. England in reply to Pakistan's 225. 100 for 2. Who's a man at forward square, but he's not going to get that. It's nicely stroked with great control by Atherton. The fact that Mushtaq's bowling into quite a strong breeze is interesting enough, but it means that the batsmen are hitting with the strong breeze if they want to hit him down the ground. Just like that. And it allows the ball to carry a lot further. Just pushed the ball a fraction too far. Gave Atherton the chance to roll his wrists on, and it went very, very fast to the boundary. The comparison between the two teams at 15 overs, Pakistan 38 for no wicket against 77. And after 25 overs, 89 for one Pakistan, England well ahead, 119 for two.
And he can smile now, but it was a bit of an extravagant sort of off drive from Michael Atherton.
Hasn't been caught. It seemed to come off the bat. I think that's again a little over exuberance from Mushtaq Ahmed. And the googly, well disguised. It's never hit a pad. It's never hitting the stump, so there's not over much to get overexcited about. That's good cricket all round. Well, Michael Atherton it was who had to do most of the work, having been on the back foot when he played the shot. He was a yard or two off the pace when Graham Thorpe called him back for the second. He'd placed it well enough. It was wide of Salim Malik at long on. And then Malik had spotted the fact that Atherton was starting a yard or two even behind the pace, and tried to catch him out. Oh, nice piece of work. Mohin Khan, very, very quick behind the stumps. And also quite clever bowling. Graham Thorpe, intent on coming down the pitch, didn't really need to do that the way England were going, but looking to keep that score rate ticking along. And he's well stranded. Couldn't get back from there, even if he'd wanted to. 23 to Graham Thorpe, third wicket falls at 146. And that was good bowling. Pushed it wide, did Aamir Sohail, as he saw Graham Thorpe coming. Graham Thorpe goes, Matthew Maynard is the new batsman.
I think it's very important for Pakistan to get Mushtaq to bowl it to Matthew Maynard straight away. Just might not be able to pick Mushy. Didn't play in any of the test matches, so he hasn't had a good look at him. And Pakistan do need a couple of quick wickets.
But in the words of his former county chairman, it's either demolition or disaster for Matthew Maynard. And Mushtaq has three overs, including this one, remaining of his allocation. Great shot. No problems picking that. In fact, Mushtaq Ahmed is the man who'll have to pick it out of the crowd. And no doubts this time, ball is carried over the rope. Six runs. Matthew Maynard not one to hang around.
Well, this was a magnificent shot. He picked it all right, he smacked it, and he left Mushtaq looking at him speechless. What to make of that?
Oh, that's well struck. Very well struck. There are two men out there. And he managed to bisect them perfectly.
Beautifully bowled.
Again, you see Matthew Maynard staying back, not wanting to come forward. It's a very full length, but he's staying back trying to work it. He might just have done too much. He might just be missing off stump.
England, in fact, are batting very well because the ball is turning a lot. There's no pace on the pitch. Bounces a little uneven. Really, the dice is loaded in favour of the bowlers. And the cheer goes up for Michael Atherton's half century. Very well taken. It can't be a century full of orthodox strokes because the pitch is difficult and the ball has turned a lot. But he's shown a relaxation and a flexibility. Very good 50. Some pretty prosperous partnerships there. Knight and Stewart 57, Stewart Atherton 41, 48 Atherton Thorpe. And now Maynard with the captain has put on 25. This field has four runs. Salim Malik is the guilty man.
Well, I suppose in all cricket matches you get an odd bit of a fielding lapse, but all in all the Pakistan ground fielding has not been up to standard today. Been a lot of fumbles and misfields, not getting to the ball quick enough.
Little uppish, and that prompted the bowler to dive across, try to take a return catch. One more to Maynard. Oh, beautiful struck. Wonderful stroke that by Michael Atherton. He kept low, it darted through. Just opened the face and played the most delicate cut shot. 40 overs gone now, and there's a comparison. Pakistan were 155 for 2. England well ahead, 194 for 3. Sakhlin Mushtaq about to bowl. Well, that should be out. It's in. Difficult one, a difficult one. They were both running for it. Maynard got right underneath that. The 200 comes up. A sort of boldness that Matthew Maynard doesn't need to employ at the moment. But he's always aggressive, always trying to dominate. The ball goes many a mile high. Look at these two fielders. Atur Rahman is the man who's under it. Well, he's scarcely got a fingernail to it. Perhaps conscious of the fact that Salim Malik was racing the other way. And it's beginning to look not Pakistan's day. Bowls him a slower ball, a slow ball. And Wazim Akram removes Michael Atherton after a fine innings of 65. This is how it happened. Little bit of leg cut about that. Beautifully bowled, very slowly. And it did the trick. ...65 from 93 balls. Very good performance by Michael Atherton. Kept rotating the strike, pushing the singles. Some nice cuts and late cuts. 5 fours. It's 200 for 4. Here's Graham Lloyd. So every batsman has really got himself in. Graham Thorpe into the 20s as well, Nick Knight. But Michael Atherton and Alec Stewart really have given the strongest lead, with Matthew Maynard helping to up the tempo. Big shout for ABW. So Mushtaq back for his ninth over. Bowls to Matthew Maynard, who was 27. Good throw in, good flat throw appeal from Bowen Khan, the wicketkeeper, but Maynard well home there. With Matthew Maynard, you can always be sure of a risky ride, but my word, the score rattles around. Just the sort of player who can make this easy for England.
That wasn't very far away. Looked a quicker delivery and might well have been the top spinner from Mushtaq Ahmed. Wakar Yunus to bowl now from the Stretford end. That away nicely, but not perfectly timed. It'll be pulled up just inside the boundary. They'll get three for it. Nicely bowled. Another wicket goes down, five down now, and still England six runs short.
It was a good innings by Matthew Maynard. Worked the ball around, particularly to the onside. This time it cannons off the pad to the stumps, but it's kept England up with the run rate easily. He's a very difficult batsman to bowl at, 41 of 53 balls. He can play and miss a little bit, but he hits the bad ball very well and very hard. Perhaps just working it a little bit too square. The wide angle that Wasim Akram bowls. Perhaps he'd have been better off working it a little bit mid-wicket rather than square, but can't complain at this stage of the match. Ronnie Irani, the new batsman, with England needing six runs to win.
He got a slower change of pace from Wasim Akram. Just pushed it off the back foot. Didn't do anything extravagant with it. And it beat the cover fielder. That's the win. Ronnie Irani has done it in two balls. 226 for five for England now. And it's a fine victory, the first of these Texaco matches. 226 for five, Irani not out six. And a very, very good performance from England.
Well, it was a very good partnership to start England off between Nick Knight and Alec Stewart. Very good tempo about it all. And then Michael Atherton, the solid man there, but easing the ball around the park and playing some big shots himself. Graham Thorpe contributed his 23, and Maynard, of course, when he gets 40, the game races ahead. So 226 for 5, and plenty of balls left. England batting partnerships, there's the opener, 57, Knight and Stewart. Stewart and Atherton, 41, 48, 54, 20, and then it was Lloyd and Irani. They too looked fit for runs. Pakistan, they struggled with the ball, and that's strange because the expectations, the potential of the slow bowlers was never realised, and the wicket-taking was left to Wasim Akram, 3 for 45, and 1 to Aamir Sohail. They see the result confirmed. England win the first Texaco trophy match by 5 wickets, and the man of the match, the England captain, Michael Atherton. And after the presentation, I spoke to Michael Atherton.
Michael, great to have a convincing win and win the man of the match prize yourself.
Yeah, the last one's a bonus, but I thought we played really well as a team today. Much better than Pakistan, and we deserve to win the match.
What about the pitch? There were so many queries. It was hot gossip at the start, wasn't it?
Yeah, the pitch looked awful, but it played okay. It was very slow. It wasn't an ideal one-day pitch, but it actually played pretty well, and it was pretty much the same for both sides. I think Pakistan found it awkward to set a total on that pitch, and we were quite happy chasing 220.
It was a moment when I was a bit perhaps worried when we seemed to concede about half a dozen to 10 singles in the field.
Yeah, I thought we were a little bit slack in the circle at one stage, but I thought our fielding in the outer and in the deep was fantastic. We tightened up towards the end of the innings, and generally our fielding was pretty good, although we lapsed a little bit, as you say.
The perfect innings, really. Lots of good partnerships, isn't it?
Yeah, when we batted, the openers got us off to a flyer, Nick Knight and Alec Stewart, and that meant the rest of us in the middle order, all we had to do was knock their spinners around, keep picking the gaps, and, you know, knock it around at 4 and over for an easy victory.
So does this help you recover now from the Test series? The boys are feeling fairly optimistic?
Well, the two forms of the game are very different. As befits the squad we've picked, you know, which is very different to our Test match squad, but the games are there to be won. We've got a trophy to play for and some money to play for.
Well, England would be cock-a-hoop. It was a top-class performance, but I think Pakistan would be disappointed. It wasn't their usual tigery selves, the ones we saw in the World Cup competition. They really are a good one-day side. They may be in better form as we follow the Texaco Trophy competition. That's at Edgbaston on Saturday and Trent Bridge on Sunday. Our next cricket. We look forward to seeing you then.